Here at Santa Anita in the final day, final equestrian competition, we have 10 riders left. And this is one of them from France, 30-year-old Frédéric Cattier, Flambeau Say, a 13-year-old chestnut gelding, French bred, coming in with 8 penalty points. In the hunt.
This is a very clean jumper, a very, very beautiful horse. Was already a member of the 1982 World Championship team. So you know that Flambeau Say with Frédéric Cattier is no slouch.
Remember, we have a tie after the first round between Joe Farges of the United States, Michael Whitaker. Clear rounds, then 5 tied with only 1 knockdown earlier today.
Good start for Flambeau Say. Flambeau had a water jump problem in the morning, and the water is in this same afternoon course. I wonder if anything will change.
Now the Beverly Hills Oxer. Biggest problem thus far.
A little bit bad. It's a very big fence.
And that's the one you described on your course walk, Bill, and showed us the spread and the height.
Well, I would like to have gotten right in the middle of it, actually, but I would have disappeared if you tried to look for me with a camera, Chris. It's a very big oxer. Not as big as the one we had at Mexico in 1968, but it's still big enough. Look at what a nice horse this is, though. You see how he comes through the 3 combination, which is also not small, and makes it look easy.
Only 4 penalty points now for Frédéric Cattier of France, coming in with 8. Total of 12 now at number 7. Now turning toward the wall, and then the water jump that Bill was talking about.
Will he jump the water this time? Yes, well clear of it this time. Oh boy.
Beautiful. Only the second round with 9 riders to go that have done it with 1 knockdown. Frédéric Cattier. The heavy hitters are coming up here at Santa Anita, and we'll be back for them.
The games of the 23rd Olympiad. Brought to you by the Coca-Cola Company and the people in your town who bring you delicious, refreshing Coca-Cola. At the 1984 Olympic Games, Coke is it. ARCO, Atlantic Richfield Company. We're proud to have funded the new Olympic competition track and to be an official sponsor of the 1984 Los Angeles Olympics. Team Xerox, the right products and the right people all working together. And local McDonald's restaurants who join together to build the Olympic Swim Stadium.
It's a good time. McDonald's.
Good time. Great taste. Good time. Great taste.
It's a good time for the great taste. It's a good time for the great taste. It's a good time for the great taste. Taste, taste, taste of McDonald's. Let's go!
On a clear round through 4 fences, the great Paul Schachemuller of West Germany. Longtime partner is Deister, the 13-year-old gelding. Oh, there's the first fence down, 4 falls.
Just sat on that rail a little bit. This is a wonderful combination of horse and rider. Twice European champions, 3 times winner of the Grand Prix of Aachen. But I think that Paul thought coming to Los Angeles that this was going to be his year for an Olympic gold. Sadly, it's not to be.
His brother Alvin winning the gold at Montreal. We were there to cover it at those games. 76 over the water and clear there. But so now, Bill, we have 2 riders with 2 rounds that have 12 faults. Frédéric Cattier and Paul Schachemuller. We'll be back after this.
Take your brother with you.
Coke for the big times.
for the small, it's for the times you're feeling 10 feet tall.
Oh, Coke can see it. It's the one you grow up with. It's the real cola taste. With the lift, with the light, to put a smile on your face. Coke, Coke is it. Coke!
United Airlines presents Daily service to Hong Kong and daily service to Tokyo. With 7 flights a week to Hong Kong and 7 flights a week to Tokyo. With United's all-new 3-class Royal Pacific service. United Airlines to Hong Kong and to Tokyo. Fly a friend to the Far East.
Only 8 riders in individual Grand Prix jumping in the second round are left. We now move to a rider that this morning had only 5.25 penalty points, Luis Astolfi of Spain.
Chris, I would say this was the only real surprise of the morning round. Luis had not gone that well in the Nations Cup. He had no less than 56.5 faults in the Nations Cup, but he jumped an excellent round this morning. And he's in a position now to put some pressure on these big shots that follow, because the real heavy hitters of our sport are to come last.
Clean at the Beverly Hills Oxer. Now to the sailboat. We have 5 combinations that are tied at 4. We have 2 riders, Joe Farges and Michael Whitaker, who this morning had clear rounds. The only 2 out of a field of 51. The best thus far, 2 rides of 4 penalty points.
Oh boy, what a beautiful jump he made over the middle fence, but he had to reach a little bit too much for the last one and couldn't quite jump it. So it's 4 faults so far for Luis Astolfi. Spain has 2 riders going late. The United States has 3 riders going late.
Switzerland has 2 going late, and Great Britain 1. 2 women in that group. Heidi Robiani and Melanie Smith. Clear at the water. Final double.
Oh. The last fence falls. He also has 0.5 time fault, giving him a total of 8.5 for this round and 13.75 overall.
We'll be back.
The results are number 1.
In the spring of 1982, Dean Witter went against the Wall Street crowd by predicting